Good morning, students. Hope you are keeping fine. Okay. In previous discussions, we had the shifting of the pressure belt. So please take today. I remind you to take your book and the pencil in hand. Today, we will be discussing in this video the condensations and the precipitations, condensation and precipitations. When you do in your science class, it is, I am going to, if you have done it, it's fine enough. If you have not done it, you will be doing. And so your science teacher will ask you, your science teacher will ask you to do one experiment. You know, what is experience? What is that? What will be that experience? Let me show you. So, the experience will be, suppose take this, it's a branch. It's a small branch of a tree or the plant. And that one has to be tied with plastic like this. If you tie the polythene, is it airtight here, like this, then what it happens is after some times, see, already I'm feeling hot inside, okay, hot inside. And so the here what will happen is after half an hour or so, you will be able to see the droplets on the plastic. On the plastic, you were inside this process, see, droplets in the plastic. And then where, and then that droplets is the same thing. This kind of things is done. The same thing is being done in the atmosphere. So what is condensation is what I'm telling you. Okay. So condensation is a process. It's a process by which the water vapor in the air changes into water. So as the plastic inside that, you'll be able to see the droplets. Water droplets. So why it is? By this, many things you can understand. Number thing is that they continuously, the branch or the surface of a tree or any living being, when it comes in contact with the sun or the air, then there is evaporation. Continuous evaporation takes place from our body also. And which the plastic, the polythene, is able to protect it. It does not allow it to evaporate into the air. And so it remains. When it is too much, then what it happens? Well, and then outside it is cold. Inside it is hot. Outside it is cold. No, outside it is cold. Inside it is hot. And so heat and cold, when it mixes, then it changes into one water vapor. Changes into, when it cools down, it changes into droplets. Another example is the condensation. The example of condensation is nowadays it is getting hot. You want, most of you like to drink the cold water. Take the water in the glass, from the fridge, pour into glass, and then keep for some times. You will be able to see outside the glass so much water droplets. Okay, so much of water droplets gathered. Why? Because the cold and outside glass is cold. Water is inside the glass, water makes the glass cold. But then what happens is outside it is hot. And so heat, it evaporates, it does not evaporate, the vapor is turned into to water droplets due to the heat. So here it is. So many things I have told you. So here it is. It occurs when air becomes saturated, or when there is a cold surface on which water vapor can condense, deposit. In the atmosphere, the surface of the condensation, surface for condensation is provided by smoke, dust. Remember, I have told you when we were doing the atmosphere, in that the air is, where about the air? Air is also the mixture of dust, smoke and so many things. So these dust and smokes are helpful for for making condensing the water droplets, and it falls down for as a precipitation. We have already said, and the cloud formation, it helps in cloud formation. This cloud may produce precipitations or rainfall, which is primary route for water to rain to return on the surface of the earth. So, and then remember the water cycle we are going to do next. So the three important forms of condensations are the dew or frost. Dew or frost. What is dew? Dew is on the in early morning, especially in winter, you will be able to see when the or in the to these days also, if you go out into the garden early morning before sunrise, then you will be able to see dews on the grass or the plants on the leaves. Dew or the and frost. Next one is a fog or mist that we see during the winter, and cloud. Yes, dew and frost during long clear winter nights. Grass, leaves, flowers, sand, soil particles and the ground cools down due to the radiation. When moist air comes in contact with cold surface, the water vapor condense. Generally people say dew falls, it does not fall, it gets condensed, deposit into the water droplets, which are observed early in the morning. These small drops of water called dew, if the ground is ground temperature falls below the freezing point, the dew drops freeze into the tiny icy crystal. This year it was very, very cold, and not in Rampurhat, other parts of India we have seen many frozen dew had become ice due to the cold, very, very cold in winter in the month of January, December and January. And this year I had a time to enjoy with this frost. Frost causes heavy damage to rabi crops. For example, these days, these are very, very, this causes heavy damage to the potatoes and all that during that time. Yet rabi crops, remember the crops name also, rabi and kharif crops, two types. Fog and mist, during the long winter nights, the moist air near the surface, earth surface, cools down below the dew point. When it comes in contact with the cold surface of the earth, water vapor present in the air condense on the dust particles and floats. What we see, white things, what we see. And then when we move on our hair, on our clothes, it gets trapped, gets deposited, and we can see. We are not able to see what is that. Further, next, when you go to school, you remember. Dense fog disturbs the air transport, so visibility is less, they say. And when there is no visibility, the air traffic will be stopped. Rail services and road traffic during severe winter, mist is thinner than fog and form the same way as fog, afford greater visibility and all that. So these are the things we have experienced, just go through. Next one is the cloud. Yes, cloud. Clouds are the most important form of condensation. After moist air ascends, it begins to cool and saturate. This condensation starts the cloud formation process. So moist air is lighter than the dry air and rises into the form of warm air current. The ascends moist air expands and loses its temperature, it cools down, and so the formation of clouds takes place. A cloud is formed when air is cooled below its dew point temperature, and so there may be the above, just above the 0 degree centigrade. The cloud is made of water droplets. When it falls, and then we call it rain. The smaller droplets of water or ice crystal condense around these particles to form the mass called the cloud. When the dust particles, it forms and then it becomes heavy. So there are falls. The shape and the height, according to the shape and the height formed, the clouds are categorized into three categories. What are they? Cirrus, stratus and columns. Cumulus, stratus and cirrus. These are the names of the three categories of clouds, cloud formation. Cirrus clouds are very high clouds that are made from the ice crystal. They are thin, feathery like things. They look very nice, white. They look white. Next one is the stratus. Next one is the stratus clouds are layered sheet-like clouds. The sheet like a sheet, bed sheet. They are found at lower altitude. Columns are lower altitude, they are not very high. Cumulus clouds are puffy. Puffy means they like smoke, they look like. Or the cotton like clouds. They are formed by vertical rising of the air. Vertical rising of the air, they are called. Other clouds are made from the combination of combination and variation of these clouds. So when they come in contact with the other forms of clouds, there is this formation takes place. The name of the cloud may also contain the prefix or the suffix. Prefix or suffix. You remember in your grammar, what is prefix and what is suffix? Okay, that tells you more about the cloud. Okay, alto, nimbus, all that, nimbus, altos are some of the examples of this. So these are the types of this. What then comes the precipitation. The precipitation, the microscopic droplets, that is tiny droplets, join together and grow in size when they become heavy and form the clouds, cannot hold them anymore. So they fall down in the form of water droplets or flakes. Precipitation is the process by which different forms of moisture releases from clouds as rain, sleet, snow or hail. Most precipitation falls as rain. Next one, different forms of precipitation. Number one is rain. Second one, rain, we say, we know, water droplets, falling of water droplets. Next one is the drizzle. That is, all the rains dropping, falling of water is not the rain. Some rains are very less, one or two drops. They are known as drizzle, less in number. And sprinkling type of, called drizzle. Snow, in the form of a tiny crystal. Temperature is below freezing point. The water vapor in the cloud freezes into tiny icy crystal called the snow and it falls to the ground. Next one is the sleet. When snow and rain fall together, it is called sleet. Very simple. This is important. Hail. These days, whenever it rains, hail you will be able to see. The other day, it rained and then destroyed the crops. The pellets of ice, small stone of ice formed within the cumulus cloud. This is colonimbus clouds, which are, this is a prefix or suffix. It's a suffix, column and nimbus. Nimbus is added. Suffix, not prefix. Suffix is added, nimbus. And so it is known as column nimbus clouds, which reach to the great height, ascending current within the cloud carries droplets of water to the upper part of the clouds where it freezes. Descending current brings down These frozen drops part of which melts and molds moisture condensed on it. This sweeps down and sweeps upwards, freezes, grows into size and shape, and same process is repeated. It's repeated. When this repeated part, when these hailstones becomes too big and heavy, they fall to the ground. When they become, and when it reaches, they are becoming small because they melt on the way. And that's why when they fall, very often we find the small one, not the bigger one, but on the atmosphere, it becomes very heavy. So these are the things I wanted to discuss. Please go through. Though I rushed it, but then if time provides, we'll discuss. And surely in the class, we'll discuss. Okay, stay safe.